how you can suggest the next awesome Excel feature. The Excel team has an awesome history of listening to feedback. You post an idea, other people vote for it, and many times those things happen. Now look, this all changed. It used to be that you'd go to user voice, excel.uservoice.com, and now Microsoft has moved to their own site. To get there, you need to go to help and then feedback. And then over here on the far right-hand side, I have a suggestion. For the longest time, this button didn't work. It wasn't hooked up to feedbackportal.microsoft.com. No one's ever going to remember this, unfortunately. I'll put the link down in the YouTube description in case it ever gets broken again. Now, the things you want to look for here, on the right-hand side, categories, you're going to choose Windows. If you're using Windows, if you're using something else, feel free to use something else. Here, I like to look for things that have the most votes. Down here under statuses, these are great. You can come here and say, look for everything. We're considering this. All right, so these are ideas. Look how many votes, 419, 412, and so on. All right, now if you have an idea, up here, click Send Feedback, Excel, type in a title, platform, Windows, select a category. I'll go with editing and formatting. Take a look here through similar feedback in this forum to see if someone has already suggested it. If not, down in the description, type your idea. There's all kinds of great formatting items down here. So if I control drag the January worksheet to the right to make a copy of the worksheet, they call it January parentheses 2. Do it again, January parentheses 3 and 4. How about using the same logic as a fill handle? When I control drag January, it should create February, then March, then April. Jan would copy to Feb, Monday to Tuesday, Mon to 2. 2023 quarter 1 would copy to 2023 quarter 2. You'd follow all the same rules already written for the fill handle. Wouldn't that be a great idea? I'll click Send. All right, there it is, 0 votes. I'm going to put a link down in the YouTube description. Go vote for my idea. And if you post an idea, leave a comment down in the YouTube description and I'll vote for yours. Before you know it, all of our ideas and your ideas, they'll be in Excel. Now, if you want proof that this works, I have a collection of what I call the greatest hits of feedback successes. I love this one. No more warnings about saving as a CSV, especially when it didn't change anything. I don't know how many hundreds, thousands of times I've told Excel that yes, I really true do mean to save this file as a CSV. I recognize that not everyone will understand the CSV, doesn't do cool formulas or formatting, but I do, and I still want to do it, and I want to do it a lot. Give me a way to opt out of these useless warnings. 1196 votes, options, save, show data loss warning when editing comma delimited files, uncheck that, no more CSV nagging. Another one of the most snarky suggestions every time. Many days a year, I train people in Excel, and someone asks why there's no button or shortcut to obtain a number format with 1,000 separator, no decimals. At least here in Northern Europe, this is the most common used number format. This one got shot down. It's there, it says comma style, and it says it'll format with 1,000 separator, but it does all kinds of other bad stuff as well. 2 decimal points, indents from the right edge, replaces zero with dashes. All right, so that one didn't work, but these did. Have Excel scroll better when there's large cells. Done. Stop Excel from changing large numbers to scientific notation. Done. Maintain leading zeros when entering values in cells. Done. Pull current stock prices and historical data into Excel. That's working. The new stock history function. Unhide multiple worksheets at once. Thank God. Done. Allow us to turn off automatic conversion to date. Not yet. Maybe. Format as a checkbox. Not yet. Maybe. Filtering needs to work on co-authoring. This was me. I wrote this one years ago. It used to be that if you were co-authoring one person filtered, it would show up for everyone. They now have sheet view. Done. Another one of mine. Allow users to set choose defaults for pivot tables, compact, tabular, classic, etc. Done. File, options, data, edit default layout. Make Power Pivot available in all versions. 533 votes. Done. Starting in Excel 2019. Look, they're there. They're listening. All of these get read. They will say, yeah, we can do this, or there's some reason why we can't do it. And every year, more and more awesome features that were sourced by the people who know Excel really well. You, the people that are using Excel 20, 30, 40 hours a week, right? We love Excel. The Excel team loves Excel. Let us share our feedback with Excel. Others will vote your idea up, and there's a good chance that you can get your feature in a future version of Excel. Well, hey, I want to thank the Excel team for being so responsive to the feedback portal. I want to thank you for stopping by. We'll see you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.